check, check. Check, check, check. Check, check, check. Let's get this shit popping.
Yeah.
Everybody good?
Yeah.
Man, what a crowd. What a crowd. What a very sexy crowd. Fellas, I'm sorry. Y'all outnumbered like a motherfucker. I think it's like two dudes in here tonight. That's it. I'm on my, four dudes. All right, let me welcome y'all to the release session. I am your host, I am Will. This is my DJ, Shottown Finest, and we are the release session. Thank y'all for coming out. This is a special show tonight featuring Diva Misdirected, Power and Poetry. And we got some other great poets on the lineup tonight. I've been waiting on this show all week. Once I seen the poet list, I said, this is going to be absolute fucking fire. All right, so with that being said, let's put out some announcements. We're going to get this thing rolling down here. Is that okay? Let me shout out first to the vendors in the building. We got Love on Purpose up front. She got some dope candles and all kind of stuff up there. We got Sunwater Herbs in the back. Sexy. She's one back there making that noise. Boop, boop. I need my shot later on. Give me my shot. We got Real Raw Naturals in the building. She gave me some body butter, and our media was like, I'm going to put this on some toast, right? She was like, no, it goes on your body. So she didn't tell me that. I'd have been eating body butter and eggs in the morning. I promise you I wouldn't. I'm stupid like that. Don't mind me. And we got Mineral Magic in the building. Back there to my left. So these vendors, they work really hard to put the product together. So doing intermissions, you go outside or to the restroom, just check them out. See if you got something that you might like. You know, we definitely want to try to support each other any way we can. I got behind me the Release Session shirts. We sell these things $15, and as always, you buy any shirt from me. Every Release Session you wear it, you get any show I do for $5. Just my way of showing appreciation for purchasing a shirt from me. All right. With that being said, I got everybody. I got all the vendors. How many of the ladies had five guys? I'm talking about the burger place. I'm just messing with you. I'm just messing with you. How many of the fellas ain't winning today? That nigga like, he got me fucked up. I ain't falling for that. I'm talking about cheeseburgers and fries. All right. If this is your first time at a release session, just do me a quick favor. Throw your hands up. Wow. Oh, wow. Wow. Dope. Let me say, first of all, thank you for coming. Hope you come back. You're in for a great time. We always have to like to have people out here for the first time to see what we do. We've been doing the show since 2008. This is show number 108. So that's how long we've been around in Dallas, Texas, doing our thing right here. We've been here at the Attaché for 2 years, and we do our show here once a month, typically every third Saturday, but we switch them up. But you can follow on Facebook, on the William Shelton Jr., Instagram, I Am Will, The Release Session, LLC. YouTube channel, you got YouTube, go to YouTube, put in the Release Session, all our shows will come up, including this show, past performances, and anything else. Anybody know me, I'm a TikTokologist, so I do goofy shit all the time. So you wanna do that, follow me on TikTok. I'm doing some stupid shit with my dog. I'm stupid like that, ignore me, don't worry about it. Like to have fun, I live life. All right, we're gonna lay out a couple rules. We ask you respect the mic. These poets, I work really hard on their pieces. So I feel like they deserve your attention. And you paid to get in here, so you deserve to hear what they have to say. All right? So if you have a personal conversation, you got a phone call, take it outside to the cafe area, take it to the restroom, because I have no problem asking you to leave. I got no problem with that at all, because this is what we do here. It's a poetry show. It's not the Bruno Mars concert, all right? Speaking of concerts, man, Babyface and Kim, you know, that's a whole nother story. Anyway. Y'all got that? That cool? Yeah. If a poet gets up here and says a particular line you like, you can say. Rewind. All right. Y'all got that, newbies? Got that? Yeah. If a poet gets up here and says a particular line you like, you can say. Rewind. That's flat as fuck. Gino, what up? That's flat as fuck. If a poet gets up here and says a particular line you like, you want to hear it again, you can say.
Rewind.
how the fuck we go. If a boy gets up here and says they got a new piece, you can say.
Oh, shit.
Yeah. Yeah. I'll do one more game. If a boy gets up here and says they have a new piece, you can say.
New shit.
I think we're ready to roll. You've been baptized. Okay, I think I got everything out of the way. Except I'm apologizing to you in advance. Tonight, you may hear some words here tonight. You may not hear on an everyday basis unless you know my mother personally. You know my mother personally? You hear these words here tonight. You hear fuck, shit, bitch, damn, hoe, goddamn, hell, motherfucker, fatherfucker. I just made up a word. I don't know. If I miss one, I'm sorry. If these words offend you, let me know. I'll refund you, and I hope you come to the next show. Is that okay? Joe, you didn't throw, Joe, I didn't get no intro music or nothing. You playing Mary J. Blige for the ladies and all this type of shit. I didn't get nothing, bro. What up with that? Yeah, and I ain't want no music now. I just want to do some poetry. Y'all ready?
Yeah.
Let's get this thing down here. I'm sorry, I gotta steal my drink right quick.
Yeah, that's pretty good. Oh, that's damn good.
All right, check. Yeah. Kong happy. So again, we ask you respect the mic. Is that Gino?
Yes, sir.
Godfather's in the building. Rain is in the building. That's how I know it's going to be an epic night. Brown Sugar Lounge is in the building.
Exactly. Yes, sir.
I was recently interviewed by a journalist who asked me about my journey, just trying to get to know me. He asked what led me to write 2 books, audition for Wildin' Out 5 times, referee 3 sports, including my spoken word poetry. He said, you're only 45. What are you trying to prove with all of this? And if something becomes a hit, would you become satisfied and walk away from all of this? I just smiled and said, I'm having a midlife crisis. Now that I write this, I realize a whole lot of truth was said in jest. So let me take a second to get this off my chest. You see, I'm not a fool to the fact I have one shot at this. And if you think you can walk away from this, then you obviously don't know me. Maybe that's a good thing. Because I have a tendency to push those closest to me farthest away. And that's just me being real, because I'd rather die than live fake. It's not that I don't want friends. I don't want roadblocks distracting me from distributing these contacts I was created to deliver. I made a whole lot of takers, and no motherfucker can mess with this gift. So let me tell you the truth. The truth is, for every one person that said I could, 5 more said I couldn't. I couldn't do this. I couldn't do that. I took the weight of my haters and put it on my back and used it as motivation for every microphone that I attacked. They said I couldn't write a novel. I signed it just for you. It's my very first paperback. And I don't want your money, bro, so take your paperback. It's just a free copy for the biggest hater that I have, and I ain't even met him yet. Because God knows I would have stopped and walked away from that laptop 1,000 times if I had discouraging thoughts running through my mind. You can call it hard work, and you can call it the grind. But for some, it's temporary. For others, it's permanent for an entire lifetime. And for this sinner who saves a great God, I just want my lifetime to be motivating and living. With a bright sign saying all things of God's impossible, I serve the same God that turned a killer into an apostle. So the last word you'll ever hear me utter is impossible. I want to do everything with excellence to exalt my God and be a sweet fragrance to his presence. Welcome to the release session. I just wanted to get that off my chest. This young lady we feature tonight, I've been knowing her a super long fucking time. The very first time I met her was at a now defunct poetry show. Well, I think it came back to life. I don't know. Called Verbal Intimacy and Deep Element. I was sitting up there, and she got on the mic, and she did the nastiest shit I ever heard. Is somebody really just turn the game on? Oh. I say, somebody wonder why the fuck is go. But she's the nastiest piece I ever heard in my life. I said, good Lord. Introduced myself. I said, your spirit, yada, yada. She came back to the next show, and I started seeing her more and more shows. And over time, over the years, she always came to spit at the release session. And it's funny because she kind of grew from here as a poet, up and up and up and up, until she turned into an absolute monster with it. Not only a great poet, turned into a super duper feeling host for me. I not only consider her a really good friend, I consider her a really dope poet and one of the greatest people I know. This is my, I believe, fourth feature for her. Yeah. Fourth feature for her, and this is her first book that I really wanted to do. Because I know when I wrote my first two books, I wanted somebody to support me. So I wanted to support her. So we got Power and Poetry by Lakeisha Williams. She's going to tell you a lot more about it. So with that being said, she had a story tonight she's going to tell y'all. But see, I'm going to bring up her real quick, introduce herself to people that haven't met her, don't know that much about her. And then we're going to get back to the poetry, and we're going to go rolling down here. Is that okay? Right. Attaché Smoke, what? Bring it up to the stage. Miss Director.
I've been like, he said who I was, so I ain't gotta say my name. I've been like really like working on this for a long time. Those that know me know this means like the world to me. So before I say anything, I do wanna say thank you to each and every one of you who have supported me, who bought a book already. We still got books over in the corner. You're gonna see Supernatural right there. She'll take care of you, I'll sign it because I don't need no more responsibilities today. You know what I mean? But for real, I do thank everybody in here for your support. Like, as a poet, we work hard and we hope that our words touch people. So the fact that not only is this my first book release show, and we sold out. Like, I did cry. People don't think I'm emotional, but I am. I definitely cried. Like, real tears.
Oh, don't cry now. Ooh.
I ain't gonna cry right now. No. But no, I do want, it really, 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 really means a lot. Like, I do want to thank, like, the poetry community because we support each other. Like, shows support shows, teams support teams, people support people. So I thank you to the poetry team. Like, DFW got some bomb ass poets. And I'm a baby in the game, man. We got some bomb poets that are so fucking creative. I'm sorry to my aunties and my mama, because I'm gonna cuss and I'm gonna say a lot of nasty shit today, so I'm sorry. Anyway, but for real, thank y'all. Before we get into this, I do wanna give my personal copy that's already signed to somebody who believed in me. Like, he talked about when he first met me, but y'all don't understand who I was when he first met me. I was so shy, I didn't even want to get on the mic. I was like super, 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 super nervous. So for Will to believe in me enough to not only grace his stage whenever I wanted to, but he allowed me to be on his team. I've never been on the poetry team before, didn't even know what came with it, but I was so grateful for the opportunity because it allowed me the stage in the room to grow. Thank you to Rain. Rain's an asshole, but you gotta love him. Like, I'm serious. Like, y'all, when you know Rain, you know he a fucking asshole. Like, you gotta love him. Like, y'all see this cover? Y'all see this? Well, Rain took this picture when I did one of the most personal poems I have ever performed. He changed my book title. I had a whole nother title in mind. So, y'all, don't mind if I give people their flowers, right? I'm sorry. Okay. But I do want to just, I'm just so grateful. And when you're really grateful about something, you just want to pour it out. So why not? I mean, this is about me, but it's about y'all. So I thank you to my friends. Thank you to my family. Thank you to everyone in here that came out to support me. I hope y'all have a good show. Will, thank you so much. This book is yours. Will did not have to pay for this book. This is his. I already wrote it. Got words in it. There you go. So I'm done talking because I'm rambling because I'm nervous, but I'll be back and I'm going to, you know, I'm going to do my thing. All right? Love y'all. Love y'all.
Much love, sweetheart. That means a lot. That really means a lot. But this is the purpose of what we do. This is the purpose of who I am. This is what me and my DJ been doing since 2008. That's what it's here for. So this is what's going to happen. We're going to take a super, super quick two-minute admission.
Go buy your book. $20.
Go buy a book. Go see the vendors. When we come back, Real Spill on deck. Lady Be Smooth on deck. And this thing about to pop off the fucking planet. That cool? Tasha Smoke! What?
Yeah. They scared to come outside. Tell the boys I'm gonna party. Tell the boys they out the way. Tell them ain't nobody safe. On my mama, on my game. We gon' put it in their face. Yeah. They scared to come outside.
Gotta need a second chance. Knowing that I love you, but sometimes I do the thing.